Hello and welcome to the new Power BI tutorial video. And in this video, I'm showing you how you can find overall first state or first state by dimension or category. So identifying the first state, let's say you are dealing with sales data, then what is the first purchase date or maybe first ship date? Or if you are dealing with the financial data, when was the first loan taken? And things like those. So many times we have to do or identify these type of dates and do the manipulation. So I want to show you how you can find the overall first date. That means by looking at the entire data, let's say we want to know when a particular transaction was started or a sales was started. And then I want to show you if, let's say, we want to view it by a particular dimension. Let's say you want to know when we gave the first credit card or when we gave the first loan. So there are like multiple categories. You have cards, you have loans, you have overdraft and things like those. Then you want to know the first date of allocation based on that. Or maybe by product, you want to know the first date of sales. So in scenarios like those, we need to know the first date by dimension or category. So before I move ahead, just a quick information that this sheet, it is a live Google sheet, and the link for this sheet, you can find it in the description so that you can easily come here on this sheet and access my videos very easily by simply searching here. The text is present here and the link is present in the column B. So if you want to know about a particular subject or anything, you can do it. Also, if you want to create your own playlist or something, by DAX or by visualization or the dashboards which I have published so far. So in that case, you can simply go ahead and utilize this information as per your convenience. So since it is a live sheet, it will be having all of my future videos as well listed over here. All right, with that, let me come here in the Power BI. So the first thing first is going into the data section, and we have the order date over here. So this is nothing but the very simple sample superstore data, which is having, you know, your customer name, when you have, in which segment you have made the sale, what is the country, region, and so on and so forth. So order date is something present over here. And if you see, if I click it over here, 3rd Jan 2017 is basically our overall first date, right? So if we have to find out, let's say we want to do some sort of a calculation that what is, how many days have passed between first sale and the current sale, which is, let's say, 17/07/2019, then we can do that using a column creation. So if I just expand that, and I can click on the new column, and when I click on the new column, it will ask me here first order date, and very simply I will just write this min function, minimum of order date, isn't it? So it will going to identify what is my first order date or what is my minimum order date, because dates are also represented as numeric backend into the system. And putting a min formula will give you this, right? So if I just correct the spelling here, first order date, and click OK, will give you the 3rd Jan 2017. Now, similar to min, you can also find the latest order date by using the max function, right? So practice that. Min I have shown you. Similarly, say last order date or latest order date, and do the maximum order date. That's sort of an exercise that you can do. All right, but if I come here in the report section and create a table, right, let's say matrix, and I have, let's say, for example, the product subcategories, like accessories as a subcategory, appliances and all, then if I use my first order date, where are you? First order date over here, and I will say I don't want to use hierarchy, but just the first order date. So it will not show me anything unless I put it in here in the column, but In the column, you can see there is just one date, 3rd Jan 2017. But let's say my requirement is that I want to know my first date based on category, right? So in those scenarios, we may have to tweak the formula, or we may have to change the way we have created the calculation, but by going not into the new column, but the new measure. Okay. So for that, I will simply going to create a new measure, and I will say first order by category or subcategory, whatever. And over here, I will going to write is again the same formula, min of order date, right? And let's check this first order date by category, and we just put it over here, first order date by category. All right, why have you not gone? Okay, if I enable that, close this. Nope, not here. Okay, probably it is a measure, that's why it is not coming. But if you see, with this, the order date, if I just click outside here, the first order by category is coming over here. The only thing is, it is coming here as a measure, right? But it shows you for accessories, what is your first order date? For appliances, what is your first order date? For art, what is your first order date? The whole idea behind this is that once you know what is your first order date, let's say by any category or anything, then using the measure that you have created, the whole idea is you can use this inside another measure. For example, you want to know what is the first and latest day, or maybe the first or the second, or by let's say customer you are looking at it, then you can use this output into another measure for further calculation, right? To know the number of days and things like those. So that's basically an idea I wanted to give you, as to how you can find the overall first date over here, right? If that's, let's say, a scenario you are dealing with, or if you have a scenario where you want to frame a calculation where you need to know what is the first date by category or something like that, then you can use this first order by category by creating a measure, simply a measure like this. It will going to give you these values by category, and we can validate as well. So for example, for accessories, it is 9th Jan 2017, and for appliances, it is 18th Jan. So accessories 9th Jan and appliances 18th Jan. So let's go ahead and try to just validate what we have done. So we have first as, sorry, not here in the subcategory, the accessories, and click OK. So for the accessories, if you see, the first order date is 9th Jan, right? And we can just double check here. Accessories 9th Jan. For appliances, it should be 18th Jan. So if I come here, and where is my filter? There you go. Appliances should be 18th Jan. If I click OK, and order date 18th Jan. So that means the output that I have created is perfectly fine. And I click OK. So this idea or this output then can be used into another calculation for viewing the a range of days or things like those. Also along with another calculation, like for example, along with these values, if you want to pull another measure, then you can also pull another measure like the one over here and things like those. But the whole idea is that probably it will not going to represent the correct value, or it does not make sense to use this or this together until and unless your user is coming and saying, hey, I want to know what is the first date when it purchased and what is the overall sales, right? In that case, it may make sense, but not like this one. So that's what I wanted to show you how you can do. Now I have created the first order by category. You may want to create the latest order by category and create a range. how many days have passed between the first order date and the latest order date in for this. So that means you will what you will going to get to know is in which category you have the maximum days or you have the minimum days. Minimum days indicates that for this category, way many days or months or years back, you know, they have stopped purchasing it. But wherever you have the high range, that means still the purchasing is going on. So some sort of threshold, some sort of ideas will come out when you will produce it. So in both the cases, I have created the first date. Now you need to create the last date and create a number of days between this by subtracting the first order from the last order date. So with that, I wanted to leave with this homework to you, and I'll meet you in the next video with a new topic.